reputation, a feel-good factor for every ground across the land. But the one standout fixture that had many rubbing their hands with glee when the list was announced, this derby on opening day. Strap in for the ride. Hoists it forward. Dina goes looking. And it's been given away. And he's...
You know, thinking about that, I think they've perfected that on the training ground because it took them seconds to get the ball to the back of the field. They really commit forward in numbers too. It's all very well built.
Liverpool are all square. That's wonderfully done. Crisp hit, true finish.
Ah, you've got to love that. Concentration, conviction, contact, and sheer class.
Chance to break. Plenty of appeals, but the referee is not interested. And there goes the final whistle. It's a so-so start. Don't draw too many conclusions from that. Early days. Any reflections on what you've seen, Jim?
Of course, winning starts are clearly more preferable, but both sides can take some satisfaction from avoiding defeat and maybe go one step further next time.
From us, many thanks go to Jim Beglin, and goodbye from us. Forward, Keane. It's come for Murphy! And it's a goal! That is just remarkable, the amount of bend he got on that.
You know, I'm not going to be hard on the goalkeeper because that moved all over the place on its journey.
Suarez.
And time is up, and there goes the whistle.
Terrific contest. It really might have tipped either way. The margins were tiny, just a goal in it. But that was enough.
Your final thoughts, Jim?
Well, to me, this is a result, Peter, that says an awful lot more than the scoreline suggests. You know, after the goal, the team just settled down and looked surprisingly comfortable and didn't really need to work too hard.
So we've reached the end of our coverage for today. Many thanks to Jim Beglin alongside me, and we'll both see you next time.
Of the first half. Up to meet it! There it is! And right on half time, that is telling!
A wonderful delivery, and all it needed was a touch.
Well, look, it's often the timing of the jump that dictates what you can do with any header, and if you get it slightly wrong, then you'll struggle, but that was beautifully met.
This defence is wary about opposition pace.
So they're just not getting too tight?
Yeah, they know that if they step up, their keeper could get a whole lot busier.
At the back. Here's Rashford.
Oh, shooting chance! They've scored! Manchester United are back on level terms. Absolutely thundered in. Keeper, no chance.
Was it just me, or did he make that look very, very easy? That was terrific skill and composure from him. He finished with such a plump.
Manchester United are able now to make their substitution. It's been on the cards for a few moments now. From this, Van de Beek with the clearance,
has a hit,
really well taken goal,
and again they hit the front.
That really was a thing of beauty, curled in effortlessly.
You know what was notable in that, Peter, was the fact that he didn't try to blast it. He chose placement instead and delivered a peach.
tremendous fighting spirit. There's a real belief that they can still have a say.
Has a pop!
Time to deliver.
Oh, that is asking for trouble.
King.
That's a mistimed tackle, and it is a penalty.
So a big, big chance now from 12 yards.
Well, I think the alternative was to stand there and do nothing while he tried to score. And obviously, he's not going to allow that, Peter, is he?
To increase the lead.
Time for a cool head, and that is precisely what he showed.
Well, that's the way to take the penalty. Stand up, pick your spot, and blast it home.
Musa Sissoko.
Forward it goes. That's gone a long way up and away. And that's that.
This win by a very competent performance. Without doubt, they were the better side. And the result reflects as much.
What are your thoughts on today's game then, Jim?
Look, a win's a win. Sometimes it's not as you'd like, but you have to find a way to produce what you need. And I thought they did that.